Ja A. Pari ruutukaappausta seuraavaksi.
This is a peacekeeping force forward base near Arusian territory. Other allied aircraft have probably been forced to make emergency landings at other airfields. We don't know much. The mission to capture the capital is nearly complete, but we unfortunately have no intel. The enemy communication satellites are down, and we have confirmed the deaths of several Arusian leaders. But our enemy was smart. They had a similar plan. Our own communication systems were destroyed at approximately the same time. We have no idea when or if they'll come back online. Stand by for further details.
Melkoinen suunnitelma.
As far as the chaos we find ourselves in these days, it's difficult to say which side pulled the trigger first. Arusia deployed an automatic intercept system with drones. Osea implemented long-range attacks to bypass them, so Arusia decided to sabotage Osea's communications and navigation technology. Arusia couldn't launch a satellite themselves, but they were still able to hack the software of the Osean transmission and navigation systems. Before Osea even noticed, half of their satellites were hijacked. That's when things got ugly. In an attempt to knock out each other's capabilities, both forces launched fighters loaded with anti-satellite missiles at the same time. Only military satellites were targeted. However, their destruction created a debris field in orbit, which wiped out scores of other satellites, both private and government-owned. What kept the world relatively sane up to that point had been free-flowing data and information. But now, those were gone. All that remained was chaos and confusion. Government and civilian broadcasts and transmissions were cut off. The flow of information had ceased. Forces on both sides of the conflict now found themselves unable to communicate with their superiors. Many of the smaller countries annexed by Arusia and yearning for their independence seized the opportunity and started their own uprisings. As for why some of Osea's military decided to break off from the main force and continue on their own, I have no idea. Perhaps there was some sort of dispute over the chain of command. The continent that had once seen wars that were only fought between Osea and Arusia was now full of numerous conflicts between rival leaders vying for power. Insurgencies were everywhere. I even heard a rumor that a group of Osean convicts had rebelled.
Yeah.
Rumors. It never ceased to amaze me that even at a crazy time like this, something as trivial as a rumor could find its way here. Communications from corporate were cut off. Apparently, the entire computer network was down. It was a wise decision to make our drones autonomous with AI instead of being radio controlled. Wise and forward thinking. Even with their GPS offline, they can still use their sensors to navigate as long as they're working properly. I'm sure the drones are still working perfectly, following their mission orders to the letter. I wish I could upload Mihai's new data to them. But without a connection, I can't upload the software to the active drones. The new ones we're making, though, there should still be enough time to upgrade those before they're activated. I'll be taking the data I've acquired away from the front lines now. Oh, and I'll be taking the girls too. I told my assistant Masa it was time to get Mihai's granddaughters ready to leave here. She's not much older than the girls, but she has a way about her, and I'm sure she won't have any trouble with them. I saw a plane flying off in the distance. I imagine it was looking for a safer place. The plane had a rose emblem on it.
Last hope. Warden Wernerin syndrooma on kyllä vakava, jos niinku kaikki satelliitit tuhoutuis.
Arusia's communication networks have been down since their satellites were destroyed. Unfortunately, we are experiencing trouble too. All of Yuzia has been affected, and we don't know when things will be back up and running. We're not even sure if this is Arusia's doing. Still, we will follow the strategy that was originally planned and move on to the next operation after liberating Farbanti. Let's get to it. Since the war began, we've been receiving communications in secret from an officer in the Arusian army.
Uh-huh.
With the capital under our control, Arusia's radical element is losing support quickly, affecting the balance of power. HQ is thinking of using the military officer as a way to gain leverage to settle peace negotiations. The officer is currently hiding in the outskirts of Anchorhead Bay, having joined up with support dispatch from the Ocean Army. The plan is that they'll take a standard vehicle to a rendezvous point at a harbor in the east part of the city, where a helicopter will be waiting. I would like the new Strider Squadron to provide escort for the officer. Cyclops will remain at the base on standby to serve as defense. With the communication network currently down in the capital, I very much doubt Arusia will be able to mount a regimented counterattack. However, it is likely that Arusia's intelligence department and the remaining forces who are aware of the officer's movements will interfere. Keep a close eye on the officer and make sure he stays safe. Our victory in Farbanti has given us a golden opportunity to finally end this war. Be safe out there. Take note that our satellite-based IFF has become unreliable following the recent communications failure. As such, target ID will be done by processing the images from the infrared cameras on your aircraft.
Uh-huh.
Objects will initially appear as unknown on your HUDs, but will be ID'd once you close in on them for a set period of time.
To the unidentified Ocean craft, this is Captain Carl of the Ocean Army. Are you here for the escort? You're not the squadron I was expecting. Are you really friendlies? Over.
This is Longcaster, airborne warning and control system for the Ocean Long Range Strategic Strike Group. Captain Carl, they're on our side.
And those two pilots we've heard about must be here too.
Okay, I hope you're right. Longcaster, are all of these really unknowns?
It's a state of civil war. The Arusian army is fighting itself. There's no guarantee the Oceans won't shoot us in this confusion.
We'll image process the unknowns caught in your camps to identify friend or foe. The process will be faster if you get a close-up, well-centered image.
Meanwhile, just run if they shoot us, right?
Affirmative. Always identify your target before you fire.
War is something I'll never get used to, but tonight has been a total shock.
Squadron's IDs. Oh, and hand me that sandwich. Strider 1, missile launched.
Thank you.
Forces. This is AWACS for the LRSSG.
Our info has been updated.
sucks too.
Something like that.
So,
if I had to bridge it, Of a military group calling itself the Free Erusians.
An unknown is blocking our scheduled route.
No response. Got a bad feeling.
Caution. Pull up.
it up until we reach the exit. IFF designations for one was an astonishing feat.
They used it to make drones that resembled Ocean fighters, and then to assassinate Harvey and put the blame on enemy fighters.
Malkin
technology only brought chaos to the world. I can't believe Rusia is responsible for Harvey's assassination.
You talk of politics, that's new.
Can't ignore a story like that, right, Trigger?
Strata 1, target acquired.
Listen up. From here on out, all aircraft are prohibited from taking off.
Bad news. Hostile armored forces outside of the tunnel. I'm thinking that we should go say hi before they ruin the general's day.
There are unidentified aircraft in the drones.
This plane is carrying civilians. We have escort fighters, but we do not intend to engage in combat. Please stand down. This plane is carrying civilians. We have escort fighters, but we do not intend to engage in combat. Please stand down.
What's going on?
Try to get a little closer. Weapon use is prohibited. Lying about carrying civilians.
No, unless she's a soldier.
Weapon use is prohibited. We've checked footage. It does seem to be a transport with escorts.
I repeat, this craft is carrying civilians. We are not here to fight.
Dr. Schroeder, tell me what's happening.
I'm sure I don't need to remind you, but do not attack the civilian liaison.
Plane. They engage in witchcraft with Belkin technology. They're responsible.
CD them ASAP.
Shit.
That's all we can do.
Uh-huh.
ID complete. The Erusian fighters. What the hell's going on?
Stay sharp.
Uh-huh.
Right. I'm shooting them down. Any complaints?
Granted.
Wilco.
Wilco. Wilco.
Strata 1. Fox 2.
How dare you interfere? I'm here to deal with that traitor.
Yeah, good work. Strata 1 has killed a bandit.
Careful, let's look out your way. Wait, don't think those Ocean big shots too. I managed to catch a glimpse of the main strike.
Don't miss.
Aim carefully.
9. Bandit destroyed. Well done. No good. Shit.
They're in my way.
I'm behind my target.
F cocks go on.
Got a sitting duck here.
To go.
They have to put data on day.
Time to inquire.
That's what I like to see.
Another story to tell my boy. Understood. All hostiles have been eliminated. Nice. General's helicopter's flying safely outside Anchorhead Bay. All aircraft, RTB, mission complete.
All hostiles, huh?
General, the Ocean aircraft is here to pick us up. The approaching Ocean aircraft.
Losing his army? Elaborate. They stole our sealed orders. It should be a piece of cake.
Uh-huh.
Are you sent by the general staff? No, we've left it at that point. I can't!
Process the unknowns caught in your camps to identify friend or foe. The process will be faster if you get a close-up, well-centered image.
Meanwhile, we just run if they shoot us, right?
In this mission, actually.
Always identify your target before you fire.
Yeah, two missions today, and that's about what I can do. It's past midnight here, where I live. So I think this is a good time to actually stop and continue in Thursday. So that's my plan next.
Okay. In order to respond to the attack on the base, Cyclops has scrambled after being on standby. We'll head up too, once our planes are ready. Oh, and LeBarth is dead.
What did you say?
Apparently, he was shot down by another Ocean aircraft after he left the area of operations. I mean, I know it was chaos, but still. At any rate, the sealed order operation has come to a close. We have no idea about a plan for going forward.
All we can do for now is watch our own backs.
What's up with the commander?
He's staying in his room. He's still alive, since we can hear him crying.
Okay.